Hello friends, welcome to your yin and yang yoga class. My name is Crystal and I will be your guide today. For today's practice, you'll need a blanket or a towel, and then a bolster, which can also be substituted with a pillow that you have laying around. Let's go ahead and use your blanket or your towel as a headrest as we lay back in Supta Baddha. Supta Baddha is also known as bound angle pose. The soles of your feet come together, let your knees rest open, and rest your hands wherever they feel most natural. Just take a few moments to find stillness and surrender your knees with gravity. Take a cleansing breath in through your nose, fill up your belly. Soft exhale, let your chest and shoulders simply relax. Lengthen your breath in through your nose. Soften your breath out. And begin to seal your lips. Cultivate Ujjayi Pranayama. It's a slightly audible breath with your lips sealed. It's a little restriction in your throat, as if you're sipping air through a straw, in and out. Use your hands to gently guide your knees closed. Take half wind removing pose and draw your right knee in. And take your thigh out and around to the side of your ribs and relax in your shoulders, lengthen your neck. Inhale, leg extension, send your heel overhead. And support the back of your leg here, and then point and flex through your ankle, opening up some space all along your backside. Full breath in. Exhale, supine pigeon. Create a figure four shape in your legs. Draw your knee into your chest. I like to wrap my hands around my shin. You can use your right elbow to push your knee forward and an opening in your hip. If you'd like to add on here, and straighten your left leg. Your left leg goes up to the sky. You can bind around your ankle or possibly your toes. Send your tailbone to the ground. Relax around your neck. Two more full breaths. Switch out to the other side. Take half wind removing pose. This time your left knee into your chest. Plant your right foot on the ground. Reconnect with your Ujjayi breath if it is faded. Inhale, leg extension. Bend your heel up towards the sky. Point and flex through your ankle and support the back of your leg. Now rest your hips and shoulders to the ground. With that little bit of movement, explore any points of tension hanging out along the back of your leg. Exhale, supine pigeon. Cross your ankle over your knee. Draw your thigh to your chest. Full deep breaths. To add on here, just straighten through your right leg. And grab a hold of your ankle or your foot, whatever's accessible on this side, honoring any differences that show up. Mm-hmm. two more full rounds of breath. Exhale, happy baby pose. As you release, grab the outside of your thighs or your feet. Your elbows come to the inside of your knees. Compress your very low part of your back to the ground. And take a few gentle rocks side to side. You can even straighten one leg, then the other. Add in a little bit of playfulness. Whatever brings a slight smile to your practice. As you come back to center, now grab a hold of the back of your knees. Take a few rocks along the length of your spine. And rock up to a seat. There we go. And take butterfly pose. The soles of your feet come together. And actually bring your feet a little bit further out than normal. Find length in your spine. And exhale, fold. If you want a little bit of support, you can actually use the bolster on top of your feet to rest your head. We'll be here for 5 breaths. And notice as you breathe what part of your body expands. See if you can get your shoulders and chest to relax on your inhale and fill up along your belly, along your low back. Inhale, slowly rise. And guide your feet together. Guide your knees together, rather. And then cross at your ankles, come into tabletop. I like to get there by reaching my hands forward and crossing through. And then bring your knees hip distance apart, your hands underneath your shoulders. So you breathe in, take cow pose. Now arch your back, lengthen across your collarbone, soften your gaze. Exhale, cat pose, round your back. Separate your shoulder blades, bring your chin to your throat. Inhale, cow pose, lengthen across your belly and chest. Exhale, cat pose, find new space along your spine. One more round each way here, friends. And come to a neutral spine. Now leave your hips right over your knees. Walk your hands forward to melting heart. Walk your hands forward, keep your elbows straight. See if you can rest your chin or your forehead down to the ground. With each exhale, your chest comes closer to the mat. Inhale, rise. To Sphinx pose, rest your hips to the ground. Take a figure 11 shape in your arms. Your elbows go right underneath your shoulders here, and then traction your hands back. Draw your heart forward. You connect with your Ujjayi breath if it is faded. Scorpion pose. I'm going to move my bolster out of the way. Here, right arm reaches out to the side. And flip your left leg up and over. Rest your cheek to the mat. This is to open up the front of your shoulder into your chest. You can leverage off your hand to find more of a twist. And make your way to center. Take cobra pose. Press your tops of your feet into the ground, lighten the load under your hands. You draw your elbows together. Exhale, scorpion on the other side. Extend your arm out to the side of your mat. Your opposite leg comes up and over. Mm-hmm. Inhale to center. Exhale, downward facing dog. I'm going to remove the blanket between my feet. Take your time in down dog to spread out your toes, warm up all along your backside here. Your feet should be hip distance apart. You feel your arms next to your ears. Settle your heels to the ground. Rest your chest towards your thighs. Go full breath in. Exhale, ragdoll pose at the top. Take a wide stance in your feet. Again, bend softly into your knees and collapse your torso between your thighs. Now, this posture is meant to release your lower back. So if your belly's not quite touching your thighs yet, widen out your stance and surrender your upper body over your legs. Bring your feet a bit closer together. Inhale, rise to stand. Take your time, let your head come up last. Exhale, hands to your heart center. And take a moment to dedicate your practice with some mindfulness to showing up to your mat today. Share your intention today through community breath. Take a supportive inhale. Open mouth, exhale. Seal your lips. Come back to your ujjayi breath. Inhale, mountain pose, tadasana. Put your hands overhead. Now find strength beneath your feet. Lift the tension up to your hands. Exhale, forward fold. Connect your hands with the ground. Release the back of your neck. Inhale, halfway lift. Now scoop up your chest, similar to cow pose. Lengthen over your belly and chest. Put your chin into your throat. And step your right foot back, low lunge. Now take a wide enough stance back that the pressure's in your front heel. There's some wiggle room in your toes here. Inhale, Anjaneyasana. Rest your hands to your thigh. Trust your hips forward and down. Bring the softness and ease back around your shoulders and over your gaze. A full breath in to lift up your chest. Exhale, plank, lower all the way down to the ground. Lead with your chest. You can use your knees for support if you need to. Inhale, cobra pose. And press your feet into the mat as your hands lift off the ground. Exhale, downward facing dog. Lift your hips up and back. Inhale, float your right toes up high. And just for this first round, open your hips, add in some movement. Square your hips to center. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, standing split. Now lift your back foot up off the ground. Trust your weight forward. Relax the back of your neck. Kick energy into your floating foot. Exhale, forward fold. Your feet come together to touch. Inhale, Tadasana, rise. Beneath your feet. Strengthen your belly. Exhale, forward fold. Connect with the ground. Inhale, halfway lift. Step your opposite foot back now. This should be your left side. Step your foot back, low lunge. Inhale, Anjaneyasana. Let's start with your hands on your thigh. Now, once we get moving a little bit, your hips feel warmed up. And then take this posture with your arms overhead. Listen to your body's needs. So both compassion and gentleness to your practice. One more loving breath to the front of your left hip. A full breath in to lift your heart. And exhale, plank, lower all the way down to the ground. Use your whole breath to make it down to the mat. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, downward facing dog. The same foot that stepped back is the same foot that lifts up high. Breathe in, lift your left toes. Explore what's happening on this hip. Is there any room to lengthen out through your top leg? Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, standing split. Pick up your back toes. And straighten through your base leg as much as you can. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, Tadasana, rise. Exhale, forward fold. Take your time on the way down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, low lunge. Your right foot steps back. Inhale, Anjaneyasana. Welcome to reach a hand or two up overhead. Exhale, plank, lower down to the ground. Use your knees for support. Your chest gets there before your hips. Breathe in, cobra pose. Exhale, downward facing dog. The same foot that steps back. Breathe in, lift your right leg up. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, standing split. Lift your back toes. Find length. Exhale, forward fold. Bring your nose towards your legs. Inhale, Tadasana, rise. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Your left foot back, low lunge. A nice wide stance. Inhale, Anjaneyasana. A full deep breath up. Exhale, plank, lower down to the ground. Inhale, cobra pose. Peel your heart off the ground. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your left toes high. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, standing split. Your back foot lifts. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, Tadasana, rise. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Your right foot back, low lunge. Inhale, Anjaneyasana. Exhale, plank, lower down to the ground. Lead with your heart. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right toes. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, standing split. Exhale, forward fold. Take your time to find full compression. Inhale, Tadasana, rise. Exhale, forward fold, connect with the ground. Inhale, halfway lift. Your left foot back, low lunge. Inhale, Anjaneyasana. Exhale, plank, lower down to the ground. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe in, lift your left toes. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, standing split. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, Tadasana. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Samasthiti. Take a moment to reconnect. Gain focus and balance. gently open your eyes. And pick your right foot up. Inhale, tree pose. On tree pose, you can start with your toe on the ground, the sole of your foot at your ankle. And as you feel more stable and balanced, you can then take your practice to the next level by bringing your foot to your calf, or even grabbing a hold of your ankle and bringing your foot up to your inner thigh. Wherever you are, shift your knee towards the back of the mat. Draw your hip bones up towards your ribs. Lengthen up, reach up high. And an unmovable object to shift your focus to. Three more breaths. Slow and steady. Exhale, Dukhasana. This is a warrior three variation with your arms out to the side and then kick your right toes back. Your chest lifted with confidence. Eventually bringing your chest parallel to the ground. Kick energy through your floating heel. Draw your belly muscles up and in to support your back. Exhale, runner's lunge. Step wide across your mat. And wiggle your toes out to the edge of your space. Rest down to your back knee. Now, if you have sensitivities in your knee, you can always use your towel or your blanket underneath your back leg. You can rest down your hands. Check in with any sensations that are showing up for you on the side. Runner's lunge is a really great posture to open up the front of your hip. This one helps relieve tension in your lower back. I'm gonna stay here, but add on to lizard's pose. Here, support the outside of your knee and lift the sole of your foot up off the ground. Your chest rolls open up to the side. If that causes any bit of fiery or sharp pain, back off, stay in runner's lunge. This should feel bittersweet. More breaths. Draw your knee back to center and take half split. This is where your front leg straightens. And then flex your toes back. And then arch your back similar to cow pose. Here, lift your chest and find length over your stomach. Soften your gaze, deepen your breath. And we're headed to the top of the mat for standing split. So lunge forward and pick up your back foot just like we did in the flow. Exhale, forward fold, your feet come together. Inhale, Tadasana, rise. And take your time to get there. Length over your spine. Exhale, hands to heart center. Just try that on the other side. When you're ready, pick up your left foot, tree pose. Now, ideally, you would match the same variation you took with your legs. So either on your ankle, your calf, or pick up your foot lifted on your thigh. To avoid the knee area to protect your joint. Now open up your hip and draw on your belly muscles. As you breathe in, reach up overhead. Find a focus point. And two more full rounds of breath. Exhale, Dukhasana. Now fly your wings out to the side. With confidence over your chest, send your floating foot behind you. Ideally, there's a straight line from your floating foot through your spine, through your head. You can press lower or parallel to the ground. Exhale, runner's lunge. Take your time and come on down to the ground. Widen out the stance within your feet so there's some room behind your knee pit here. Now it's completely natural for your hips to have different sensations from your right side to your left. Just acknowledge anything that shows up for you. Honor its differences. Let's take lizard pose. And lift the sole of your foot off the ground. And so use your hand on the outside of your knee. Instead of pushing, we want to actually show it some support here. Rotate your chest open. Leave some room between your bottom shoulder and your ear. Come on back to center. Take half split. This is where you straighten your front leg. Shift your hips back. Find some extra length here. Arch your back. Flex your foot. Notice if you are holding your breath or if that audible rhythm and sound of Ujjayi is still there for you. Comfortable breath in. We'll take standing split at the top. Now lunge forward. Pick up your back foot. Exhale, forward fold. Bring your feet together. Inhale, Tadasana, rise. Gather energy. Exhale, hands to heart center. Connect with your dedication, your Ujjayi breath if it is faded. Inhale, Tadasana. Exhale, forward fold. Take your time to connect with the ground. Sink your belly button closer to your knees. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plank. This time, both feet walk to the back of your mat. Exhale, lower all the way down to the ground. Feel free to use your knees for support to get there. This time we'll take bound locust. This is where your hands bind behind your back. Zip up your legs. Inhale, lift your feet, lift your chest. Now hold it and see if there's room to send your fist towards the sky and lengthen the back of your neck. Exhale, child's pose. Ascend your hips towards your heels. I like to use a towel or a blanket underneath my forehead on this one. And you rest down with the top of your forehead to touch and rest on your props. And take five full rounds of breath. Tabletop. We are headed to pigeon pose. I like to use the towel or blanket underneath one hip and then the bolster underneath my chest. We'll be here for quite a bit, so just to get yourself comfortable. Favorite way to get there is from downward facing dog. I'm going to kick your right leg up and bring your knee behind your wrist. Now there is some space between my hip and the ground, so I'll use a blanket or a towel to sneak under there. And then draw your bolster or your pillow underneath your stomach to rest down. I'm gonna get my clock started over here. We'll be here for a full minute. Rest your cheek down, your shoulders and hands surrender. More full rounds of breath. And press into your hands. And take your right knee, sweep out from underneath you. Send fresh blood flow to your knee and ankle. I'll switch out to the other side. And from downward facing dog, take pigeon on your left. Kick your leg up. Sweep your knee through. Use your blanket or towel to support your left hip. And then you want your bolster not just to support your head, but to come underneath your stomach and support your torso. Rest down. Relax your fingers. Let your arms and shoulders relax. Exhale to melt into your space. Surrender with gravity. And take three more full breaths, slowly and deeply. Some counter movement here, like what you did on the other side. Just open up fresh blood flow to your knee and foot. We'll end today's session in one of my favorite postures, supported fish. Really great one to let go of tension around the shoulders, open up the heart. Actually sit on the ground and use your bolster behind you. I personally like my legs straight out with a little support underneath my knees, so that's what I'll use my blanket for. And then your bolster pillow in close. You lay down, extend your arms out to the side. Ideally, your palms face upward here. Press the bottom of your hairline towards your pillow. Close your eyes. If you have an eye covering, that's nice here as well. An eye pillow or a cloth just to cover and release some pressure around your eyes. Over your forehead, release your jaw, full breath into your chest. As you exhale, let go of any heaviness held. Scan your body for any areas holding tension. When you come across an area, any bit of discomfort, see if you can let it go and release as you breathe out. Take 5 more mindful breaths. Some light to your fingers and toes. Wiggle in your elbows and your knees. Lift one leg up and the other. So support your lower back as you come into a fetal pose on your side. You can use your bolster for support. Use your top hand to lift up to a seat. As you breathe in, reach up overhead, gather supportive energy. Exhale your hands to your heart. Carry that energy with you. The light and love in me honors and bows to the light and love in you. Namaste, friends.